Good afternoon. We extend a warm welcome to one and all as we gather in faith to celebrate Christ's love for us in this Eucharist. My name is John Sweet, and leading us in prayer today is Father Jim. Today we welcome our Boy Scouts and our Girl Scouts as they join us in the celebration of Mass. This evening, the Scouts will assist us as welcoming greeters, lectors, altar servers, and gift bearers. In today's gospel, Jesus proclaims, "You are the light of the world." He affirms that the way we live and work becomes the light that ushers us in the kingdom of God into our world today. Let us begin our worship of God now by raising our voices together with the hymn, "Come." Now is the time to worship, found in your programs. But first, in the warmth of Christ's love, let us rise and greet one another.
Welcome. We gather and pray in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
We are celebrating the fifth week of the Ordinary Times, moving along through the Gospel of Matthew, and we're honored to have these Scouts who are before us. They show us those values and virtues that we hear so prominently presented in the Gospel of Matthew in the Sermon on the Mount. And so we'll be following the Sermon on the Mount for a few weeks, looking for that goodness and grace that is there to be a part of our lives. For the times when we have failed to live up to such goodness and grace, we take a moment to ask God to forgive us our sins.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you're the light of the world that lives within us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
People. Christ, only begotten Son. Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, on earth peace to people of good will. Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will.
Let us pray. Keep your family safe, O Lord, with unfailing care, that relying solely on the hope of heavenly grace, they may be defended always by your protection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, share your bread with the hungry, shelter the oppressed and the homeless. Clothe the naked when you see them, and do not turn your back on your own. Then your light shall break forth like the dawn, and your wound shall quickly be healed. Your vindication shall go before you, and the glory of the Lord shall be your rear guard. Then you shall call, and the Lord will answer. You shall cry for help, and he will say, here I am. If you remove from your mindset oppression, false accusation, and malicious speak, if you bestow your bread on the hungry and satisfy the afflicted, then light shall rise for you in the darkness, and the gloom shall become for you like midday. The word of the Lord.
Just man is a light in darkness to the upright. The just man is a light in darkness to the upright. A light rises in the darkness for the upright. He is generous, merciful, and just. It goes well for the man who deals generously and lends, who conducts his affairs with justice. The just man is a light in darkness to the upright. He will never be moved. Forever shall the just be remembered. He has no fear of evil news. With a firm heart he trusts in the Lord. just man is a light in darkness to the upright. With a steadfast heart he will not fear. Open-handed he gives to the poor. His justice stands firm forever. His might shall be exalted in glory. The just man is a light in darkness to the upright.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. When I came to you, brothers and sisters, proclaiming the mystery of God, I did not come with sublimity of words or of wisdom, for I resolved to know nothing while I was with you, except Jesus Christ and him crucified. I came to you in weakness and fear and much trembling in my message and my proclamation. Were not persuasive words of wisdom, but a demonstration of spirit and power, so that your faith may not rest on human wisdom, but the power of God, the word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "You are the salt of the earth, but if salt loses its taste, with what can it be seasoned? It is no longer good for anything but to be thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city set on a mountain cannot be hidden, nor do they light a lamp and then put it under a bushel basket. It is set on a lampstand, where it gives light to all in the house. Just so, your light must shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your heavenly Father." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. One of the elements that I love of the St. Joseph campus, with my office being nearby to it, is the church and the tower above me where I stand right here, standing up 45, 50 feet in the air. And it's kind of a high point. We're a little bit of a hill that's here. So when the sun comes out, especially times like around evening, is this tower just glows in such a beautiful way. I suppose if you were on Lapeer Road, you'd see it in the morning. When the sun's kind of falls upon it. And it really just warms the heart when that takes place. Might have a place around your house. I know growing up at the house I grew up at, there was a tree line that would always pick up the sun. It was just like, wow, that is just, it kind of warms my heart and brings me alive when I would see that light. And especially in Michigan during January, during the winter months, is you can go a long time without seeing the sun. And we've had a couple spells like that in this past winter where it's been, I know the one was like about 3 weeks without seeing the sun, and you get a little bit anxious. And it was here, in this tower, that I saw the sun for the first time. I was like a kid at Christmas. I'm like, the sun is out! So it came out, it was supposed to come out the next day, but it came out like at sunset. I'm like, oh my goodness, I gotta go see it. Of course, it was blocked by the clouds over in the horizon, but the tower could see it. And the tower was aglow. And it was that absence of sunlight that really kind of made my heart come alive. And some of that those dynamics are being seen here in the readings that we have. I want to focus a little bit about that because obviously the tower is, it doesn't have a light in it by itself. It doesn't glow by its own power and virtue. It is clearly the sunshine that's falling upon it that allows it to radiate. And that's a helpful thing for us too, because when we talk about being the light for others, we should always be mindful that what we're doing is we're allowing God to shine in our lives. And we reflect virtue. We reflect God's ways. And that's how we can bring the light to the world around us. A little bit of Bible background here is we're in Isaiah. We're actually late in the long book of Isaiah. Isaiah is a big first section where it was the time and writings and movement of Isaiah. But Isaiah was such a popular and important figure in his time that people wanted to imitate him and continue his style. So he had a bit of a school of Isaiah that was going on that followed along afterwards. And after Isaiah's ministry, you know, a period of time took place, and then they had the, but his school was still going on 100 years later, and you had the Babylonian exile. And those who still had the spirituality of Isaiah did a second book during the Babylonian exile, just before it and into it. And then a final, the last 10 chapters of Isaiah is considered to be at the end of the Babylonian exile, which is a good 50-year period where Jerusalem was conquered and they took up all the resources and anyone who could do something and be of service to the great Babylonian Empire was carted off and was at the service of the Babylonians, hence the Babylonian Empire. And I give you all this background for a reason, because when we hear the reading, first reading about being a light, you know, that this light that will heal you, it will bring a great sense of consolation. The healing was all about the Jewish people had been living in a darkness and allowing that darkness to become a part of who they were. And for 50 years, they had been living this way. And so it was towards the end of this book, where you get 3rd Isaiah, and it's talking about the Jewish people coming back to Jerusalem and re-encountering the light. And the darkness was great in these pagan powers that were around the Jewish region, and some of the darkness. I mean, they did child sacrifice and things like that. And when you read the chapters before this chapter we have of 58 of Isaiah, it talks about that. You read the chapters and you're like, what's going on? You read the footnote and talks about some of the practices and idolatry that the Jewish people were starting to get involved in because they had 50 years where they lost contact with their faith. And that's a darkness. That is a huge darkness. And we don't have anything like that we can attend to or we can identify with. But we have a darkness that we've been seeing for decades now. You know, we can look back to the growing secularization that's been taking place in our culture, where we've moved away a lot of the Judeo-Christian values, which were always just presumed and understood to be a natural part of our cultural fabric, especially in the West. We talk about the West, the European, the American, the different countries that draw their heritage from that European experience have been drifting away in a secularization. We've been seeing this for many years. I remember when they did the Constitution, I think this was back when Benedict had just become Pope, and in Europe they did a constitution for the European Union, and they omitted anything about Christianity as being their heritage or their roots. It wasn't in there. And certainly the powers that be and Pope Francis or Pope Benedict protested about this, about why, if you're honest, you're going to put it there. They didn't want it in there. And that's kind of the later, that's the idolatry that we've kind of drifted into in our own modern times. And we see it constantly as we lose our perspective. I talked about this last week as well, you know, that we turn into the individual becoming kind of the authority of all that is. So we've had our own form of Babylonian captivity for the last 50 years in a cultural way. We need that light, and we feel it. We feel it, and there's a woundedness that can happen in our mind and our distractions, and it might come from materialism. We live in a sense of trying to manage, if you will, and humanity's really never had to do this a lot the way we have to do it now, but managing to a certain degree our free time. Managing how we enter into, and I love the Latin languages that talk about entertainment as being diversions. As I said, the electronic entertainment that we might engage in, really just diversions from what's important, from deeper moments of the course of our day. And so we look to have light, and I know the scouts who honor us today by their presence, that's a huge fundamental element of our scout. Our troop here is 186. It's produced more Eagle Scouts than I'm aware of any other scouting troop I've ever worked with. They're just fantastic. We just had another one this past week where a young person became an Eagle Scout. Why? Because they focus on virtues, they focus on all the many badges they have to do. It's all these badges to learn lesson, to inculcate the virtues that we want to share. Common virtues that we've taken for granted for many, many years. Now we got to focus on them. And so that's a good reminder that's what scouts do, is they focus on the virtues. That's what we need to do too, so that we can be a light to people. And again, we don't have to be the ones who shine from our own light. We reflect God's light. And I in this past year, I've been very attentive to the fruits of the Holy Spirit. Because the fruits of the Holy Spirit are more the subtle elements of our human journey. The joy, the patience, that understanding we get as a gift that turns into this sense of gentleness and meekness of heart that we held up last week as the one of the Beatitudes. So we can take on these virtues. Sometimes we challenge ourselves, I need to do more for my faith. I need to have all these excellent prayers that I've memorized or devotions that I'm doing, and I need to master all these different elements of the faith at that level. Sometimes it's just growing in the simplest of virtues of joy, love, patience, these elements. And we do that, we're reflecting God's goodness. That's His fruit shining in our lives in a way that helps this world. And simple ways. And we can't change everything, but we can change the sense of light that we have in our own lives. It's meant to shine out before all. I like the image of salt. We began the salt and light. The salt, salt really sodium chloride, can't lose its flavor. I like to point that out. And what Jesus is talking about is a lot of their salt came from the Dead Sea region. And because it came from the Dead Sea region, a lot of it was contaminated with other minerals and things that looked like salt but really weren't salt. So the true salt that was a part of their gathering of salt crystals, what's left, and they go to use it, well, it's no longer the sodium chloride part has actually been washed out. It's only the contaminating elements that remain. And that can happen to us in our modern world as well, you know? We get contaminated, and if we're not careful, we don't protect the salt, it gets washed away. And we see that with people in faith, don't we? Is we see how people, you know, they're living their life and they lose that hunger and appetite for the true salt that it takes, and they're only left with the mineral, the carcass, if you will, of the salt crystals. And so they think they know what this salt is. They think, oh, that salt has lost its flavor. It's useless. Well, it's not even the salt. People do that with the church a lot. They'll see the church and they say, oh, the church is corrupt. The church is this. The church is all these negative things. Well, that's not the church. Your experience of the church has been so contaminated that you see only the shell of what you think the church is. And people lose that. So for us as well, you know, we have to fight that. We have to kind of challenge ourselves. It's like, am I dealing with true salt that has flavor? Or am I dealing only with the contaminations of the salt that have no flavor and that are useless, as Jesus talks about? That's what we have to challenge ourselves when we come here, is to receive the salt that gives flavor to our lives. Allow the goodness and grace that happens as we participate in the ways of God to become godliness in the way that we interact with the world that is around us. Allowing this Eucharist and the Eucharistic experience to saturate us, to truly make us a people of God, a true people of light in a world of darkness. Our brothers and sisters, we rise. We turn to that creed, which is a form of light that reinforces the teachings of faith that we have as we now pray, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With confidence in our Lord Jesus Christ, who is ever intercedes for us at the right hand of the Father, we bring to him now these our prayers and petitions.
Let us pray for the church. Lord Jesus, may the universal church, along with our own parish, be beacons of light to the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for enduring light, dawn through our darkness, O God, and lead us to your light. Strengthen peacemakers around our globe, bring wars to an end, and make us all instruments of peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the lowly. Let your light shine upon the poor, O God. To the homeless, may we give shelter, to the naked clothing. Help us share our bread with the hungry. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the sick and those who are suffering. Bring comfort to our brothers and sisters in pain. John Drake, Val Roberts, Ryan Washburn, Janice Ford, and to all who have asked for our prayers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us remember the dead. Draw our loved ones from death to the light of the eternal joy, O God, especially David Hake, Norbert Sage, Judy Jenkins, Thaddeus Marcola, Richard Conklin, Charles Fretz, Tom Urban, and Ty Corey. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our personal needs in a moment of silence. Father, of us all, may our brothers and sisters who are preparing for baptism come to know the unconditional love. Bless our scouts and all the young who perform acts of service in our communities. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And now, following the directions of our Archbishop, Alan Vigneron, we turn to the prayer for priestly vocations, and we take a moment to pray. Heavenly Father, Lord of the harvest, call forth vocations to the priesthood from our archdiocese and families. Jesus, eternal priest, give us men willing to sacrifice and serve. Make their hearts after your own sacred heart. Holy Spirit, everlasting love between the Father and Son. Strengthen, inspire, and set men on fire with divine charity. Grant them the courage to say yes to their vocation. Immaculate Heart of Mary, pray for us. St. Anne, pray for us. St. John Vianney, patron saint of priests, pray for us. Lord our God, receive these, our prayers and petitions, that we bring to you through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, he who is light to the world. He is the source and font of all grace and goodness. He who lives and reigns with you forever and ever. Amen.
Child of the light, I want to follow Jesus. God set the stars to give light to the world. The star of my life is Jesus. In him there is no darkness at all. And the day are both alike. The Lamb is the light of the city of God. Shine in my heart, Lord Jesus. To see the brightness of God, I want to look at Jesus. Clear sun of righteousness, shine on my path and show me the way to the and the day are both alike. The Lamb is the light of the city of God. Shine in my heart, Lord Jesus.
My brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name,
for
our good and the good of all his holy church. O Lord, we bring to your altar these offerings of our service. Be pleased, O Lord, to sustain us in our frailty and grant that we may become for us now, that they may become for us now, the sacrament of eternal life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world and all its wonder. To rule in your name over all you have made and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you, O Lord, as in joyful celebration we now acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to the glory of your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, so that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night Jesus was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, Heavenly Father, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, and giving you thanks, Heavenly Father, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
The mystery of faith.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit, in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church here on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Alan Vigran, Archbishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you, and in your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. For there too we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. We rise, my brothers and sisters, and at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, My peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not upon our sins, but upon the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer to each other. Oh, that's your line.
Let's offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace of Christ be with you, thank you.
Lamb of God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us, Lamb of God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of grant us peace.
Behold, my brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God, he who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy of the gift of my heart, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body of Christ.
Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you. If you lead me, I will hold your people in my heart. I'm a Lord of snow and rain. I have borne my people's pain. I have wept for love of them. They turn away. I will break their hearts of stone. Give them hearts for love alone. I will speak my word to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go. If you lead me, I will hold your people in my heart. Lord of wind and flame, I will turn the poor and lame. I have set a feast for them. My hand will save. Finest bread I will provide till their hearts be satisfied. I will give my life to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will call, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. When I feel afraid, think I've lost my way, still you're there right beside me. And nothing will I fear as long as you are near. You are near me to the end. My word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. My word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I will not forget your love for me, and yet my heart forever is wandering. Jesus, be my guide and hold me to your side. I will love you to the end. My word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. My word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Nothing will I fear as long as you are near. You are with me to the end. My word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path.
Let us pray. O God, who have willed that we be partakers in the one bread and one chalice, grant us, we pray, so to live that, made one in Christ, we may joyfully bear fruit for the salvation of all the world through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now please be seated for the announcements. Okay. Let's see. The seniors are invited to come and join the fun this afternoon or tomorrow at 1:30 p.m. in Marion Hall for senior bingo and homemade soup. Sunday afternoon, 1:30 p.m. Please see the voice or our website for details on all upcoming events and opportunities, including our monthly Spanish Mass will be this coming Saturday at 6 p.m. The next Bravehearts event with Mass and Conversation led by Larry Denninger on Faith and Fiction, How Stories Can Strengthen a Man's Faith, on Saturday morning, February 18th, beginning at 8 a.m. A light breakfast will be served following the Mass. We're blessed to have several writers who are a part of our community who build us up with their inspirational words. The ongoing collection for bottles for babies donations is, you can still find those baskets with baby bottles near the doorways of the church in the vestibule. Again, that's for the Oxford Pregnancy Center and the wonderful work they do up there. And finally, the world's most famous weather forecasting groundhog, Punxsutawney Phil, saw his shadow when he emerged from his burrow early Thursday morning. That forecasting, that would mean that he has six more weeks of winter, so don't put away your hats and mittens. I love the sunshine we've been getting lately, but it has been a bit nippy, so we need to be prepared for that. Interesting announcement. Okay, and then... reports from Punxsutawney Phil. All right, and the final thing as we have is the blessing for our scouts. I invite the scouts who are present to step forward over here, and then please stand up here in front of me as we ask for God's blessing to be upon these scouts and the wonderful they work to do to build up our community here at St. Joseph. Almighty God, bless these young people who have committed themselves to the pursuit of scouting. Allow their minds to be broadened, their hopes to be raised, and their futures filled with promise as they grow in knowledge and wisdom through scouting. As they learn more about you, Heavenly Father, and your ways, may they be inspired to reach out in service to all in need as they strive to become disciples in our world today. May all their efforts guide each of them to know, to love, and to serve you now and throughout their lives. We ask this blessing to be upon them in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And a big round of applause for our scouts who are gathered here for today. Good job. We all rise now for God's blessing. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God's blessing be upon you in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are they who are pure in spirit, theirs is the kingdom of God. Bless us, O Lord, make us poor in spirit. Bless us, O Lord, our God. We are the light of the world. May our light shine before all, that they may see the good that they do and give glory. Blessed are they who are meek and humble, they will inherit the earth. Bless us, O Lord, make us meek and humble. Bless us, O Lord, our God. We are the light of the world. May our light shine before all, that they may see the good that we do and give glory to God. Blessed are they who will mourn in sorrow, they will be comforted. Bless us, O Lord, when we share the sorrow. Bless us, O Lord, our God. We are the light of the world. May our light shine before. Give glory.